Hey there, my name is Kathy. Welcome to the Junk Shack, baby. Today's video is another foreclosed home. My friends bought this. They didn't have a whole lot of work to do on this one, but they bought it on the courthouse steps and went in, repaired everything, new flooring, new carpet, cleaned it all up, new paint, and she decorated it, and I cannot wait for you to see it. This house is currently for sale. This place is a 3-bedroom, 2 full bath, 2 half bath home. There is an option for a 4th bedroom. It is called the study. That's what we were calling it. It's this room right here. If you needed another bedroom, you could easily put a wall and a door right there and have that. Excuse me, I need to add right here that this is all before footage. They had only owned it for about a day. It has a really good sized living room right here on the main floor off the front door. It adjoins a dining room with a nice deck and sliding glass door and a really good sized kitchen, pretty big. They did replace all of the appliances, so the appliances are brand new. They put all new flooring in, all new lighting, painted everything. I think at least the kitchen got a new faucet and maybe the bathrooms. The house was built in 2013, so it's not even that old or even outdated. She has a good way about her, just adding the little touches that really bring the coziness home and make her home sell. Usually her homes go for more than listed. And you can see why when we get to the final walkthrough. They just do a really good job. This place didn't need as much work as some of them I have seen. I think they got lucky. They needed a little bit of a break. But it looks pretty nice. And there is a lot of space in this house. I even talked to my husband about maybe we need this house. It's a little bigger than ours. But actually, we don't need a bigger house. It just, you know, you always want something bigger, but we don't need it. If I had it, though, that would be my bug-out pantry. I would fill that in and put doors in it and fill it with all the food. Great attached garage that you can get to from right there near the laundry room. They clean the places out and put all the stuff here in the garage, and then when the dumpster's delivered, they fill the dumpster. This is the hall bathroom at the very top of the stairs. It is shared with 2 spare bedrooms. And it's pretty nice. Again, didn't need any updating. They cleaned it all up really nicely and painted it. Here is the master bedroom, a really good size. It has an attached, nice master bathroom and a walk-in closet. I really liked the view from these windows. The house is situated in a court and you can just see all the way up the street and all across the whole little neighborhood. Really good size bedroom. The bathroom, again, really nice. I don't think they did a bunch. Maybe a new faucet. I'm not even sure they needed to. I know it got a paint job. I know it got new lighting. I know it was cleaned up really nicely. But other than that, it's in really good shape. For being it's not even that old, this house is still good for 25 or 30 more years. Has a great little linen closet. Although that's not very big, you might be shocked at what you would keep in there in your own bathroom. And then the attached walk-in closet. Again, a really good size. You can fit everything in here. This is the first spare bedroom. Again, another good size. Two-story homes provide that for you, good size bedrooms. Here we are in the second spare bedroom other than the master. But first, a really nice linen closet. Store your towels and sheets for these two bedrooms. Again, another good size bedroom. Another cool thing about two stories is the staircase. Man, throw a bunch of Christmas at that and bam! Really nice sized deck, and the property sits above the neighborhood. Just makes for a great view for morning coffee. The property extends into the woods that you see right there pretty far. You could make a cool little nook to sit and read a book. Roomy walkout basement. They were working on the plumbing at the time. The place had been turned off for a couple of months, maybe even a year. Looks like someone cut some hair down there at one point. But boy, you could finish this off, put a little bath, half bath down there, have a great family room and walk out onto your little patio, have a hot tub. Oh my goodness, I was in heaven. They repaired all of the plumbing, but other than cleaning it up a little bit, I don't think they did anything else to it. Here I come back, it's maybe a week and a half, no more than 2 weeks later, and they have laid the new floor. I believe the carpet was due to be installed in the next day or two. They pull up all the trim and replace all of that. This is the time that she works on any feature walls. She catches up on painting. She installs new light fixtures. This is really the time she steps in after the guys do the hard work. And she puts those final touches that actually stay with the house on it. Later, you'll see she comes in and decorates them, and they look so good and is actually what makes them sell. The master bedroom became her pet, and she put a really cool feature wall in there. Look at that. New deck. New steps. The railings were all in good shape, but all the top boards have been replaced and the deck boards. What a great house. I love this house. She also put a feature wall in the study. This house was about to be listed on the MLS. I needed to get in there and get this footage before it actually went up for sale. So she still had a couple of little things to do. She was actually decorating as I filmed. It's not hard to see why their homes sell for more than listing. When you put out a quality product and you decorate it the right way, people offer more money than the listing price to assure they get the home. She is still staging right there. Shh.
Thanks a bunch for watching. See you guys next week. Same time, same place. Junk Shack, baby.